Today we get started with this series on Islamic philosophy, theology, and Sufism. And I just wanted to ask you, even before we begin, what is it that you all are interested in, you know, learning about? We'll cover different personalities. And what I was thinking of doing is that we would start with Al-Kindi, and then after that talk about Al-Farabi, and then Ibn Sina. And that really kind of covers the Mashai school of philosophy, of Islamic philosophy. And then we'll talk about Al-Ghazali and Ibn Rushd, and kind of the debate between Islamic theology and philosophy, and what their interaction was, and how that kind of changed the course of Islamic philosophy. One of the difficulties of approaching Islamic thought, the Islamic tradition, in today's context especially, is that in the West, when these different schools of thought in the Islamic world would kind of debate one another and critique one another, the idea was, though, that it was always within the qadr, or the unity of tawhid. It's kind of like they're different branches on a tree. Our sciences can be integrated. All of our sciences are interrelated. All of our sciences have a universe of discourse in which you can draw analogies. Whereas in Western thought, because they've got that hole at the very beginning, so to speak, in a sense they deny metaphysics to begin with, all of their forms of knowledge, nothing is related. It's all fragmented. If we get our starting point right, then everything flows beautifully. If we get our starting point wrong, then we're in a world of trouble.